Good evening, my dear children in Christ. Today I am with the Word of God, Farmer and His Cultivation. Our Lord was right from the beginning. He was a farmer, always cultivating, always doing farming, sowing His seeds of words into the hearts of human and trying out the fruitful, your fruits in it. But always from the beginning, he has been failed. The one who has made him success is Christ. Let us also follow the way that Christ has been fruitful to the Lord. The seeds were sown in him, and he had shown the fruitful life for the Lord, what he wanted. So my dear children in Christ, let us all be united and be in his cultivation, the Lord's cultivation, being he the farmer. Let us all bow down ourselves unto him and follow his commands. As right from the beginning I was saying, the Lord was a farmer. And what was his cultivation? I like to read Genesis 1:11, where he says, let the earth produce all kinds of plants, those that bear grain and that those who bear fruit. And it was done. I'm talking about the creation, the early times. The Lord created the universe, the earth, the sky, the light and the darkness and everything. And one of the creation was the plants, where he said, let the plants have their own produce, let them grow into their own seeds and grains. And I'm taking the portion of the cultivation. He is being a farmer. I want to highlight that he was right from the beginning was sowing his creation into this world and was seeing that it was fruitful. And he said, let there be light, and that let there be sea, let there be water. All that creation was nothing but sowing that. Lord being a farmer, he was sowing all this for the human to have fruitful life on the earth. So let us concentrate on the farming and cultivation, how he was trying from the beginning. Now I would like to highlight the verses which I read just now, Genesis 1:11, where he says, he commanded the earth by his word, saying that let all kind of plants bear grain and bear fruits. And it was by his command, it was done. And he sowed his word of command onto the earth, and it was fruitful. And until now, it has been fruitful. And what about the human beings? He has created a human, the Adam, and he could not get the success. He failed in disobeying the Lord's word. The words were not sowed, were not sowed properly into the heart of Adam. No, but Adam was not up to the mark of the Lord, and he was not obedient to the Lord. That is where he failed in producing the fruits what the Lord want. Let us come to the verses, how the Lord is a farmer and what is the cultivation he is doing. How he is a farmer and where does he do his cultivation. Let us go to the chapter Genesis 2:5. He says, there were no plants on the earth, and no seeds had sprouted, because he had not sent any rain, and there was no one to cultivate the land. But water would come up from beneath the surface and water the ground. Earlier, when the plants were produced, the plants were grown, it was only through the word of Lord. They had all taken birth. But there was no water, the farmer who was giving water to these plants. In chapter 2:5, it is said that it is from the ground level of the water was supplied to the plants. The water was into the ground, and the water was used by the plants by themselves. But where the cultivation has come is, he said to the Adam, and take over the earth, and you multiply yourself and cultivate the land and be fruitful. And this verses I would like to refer is Genesis 2:15, where he says, then the Lord God placed the man in the Garden of Eden to cultivate it and guard it. And he said, he put the Adam, after creation of the Adam, he put the Adam into the Garden of Eden, where all sorts of trees and plants were there. And there he said, you cultivate this garden, Garden of Eden. And there, and God wanted Adam to cultivate that land as a farmer, and be fruitful. But coming to the third chapter, Genesis, where Eve have eaten the fruit which was avoided to eat, and she ate and she brought the fruit to Adam even. And there they were sinned against Lord. What is sin? Sin is nothing but disobeying God. And she disobeyed the God that she should not eat the fruit, but she went and had the fruit. She was inspired by she was tempted by the Satan talk. And this type of temptations are always there, human beings. We need to follow words of the Lord as Jesus had followed. Even Jesus was tempted in the chapter 4, Matthew chapter 4. After the baptism, he was driven out by spirit and he was tempted by the Satan. Yeah, tempted by the devil. Here, the first Adam, he could not rule out the Satan over there. So he was failed to our Lord. The Lord had sent the Jesus, but he has taken the word into his life, into his heart, and he could do that cultivation what the Lord wanted to him to do it. So my dear children, I'll come to the next word, saying that when this cultivation was given to the Adam of the Eden Garden, he couldn't do it because of his sin. So because of his sin, even the earth was cursed. Let us see how the earth was cursed. Genesis chapter 3, 17 to 19, he says, and he said to the man, you listened to your wife and ate the fruit which I told you not to eat. Because of what you have done, the ground will be under curse. The ground, the land, the cultivation land which was given to the Adam in the Eden Garden was cursed, was punished just because of Adam and Eve's sin. You will have to work hard all your life to make it produce enough food for you. Earlier, there was no need to cultivate. The water was coming right from the ground, as we read in chapter 2, Genesis chapter 2 and 5. It said that the water come up from beneath the surface and water the ground. So it was automatically done by the ground, and the roots were taking the water. But here God has punished the earth and punished the man also, saying that you have to work hard to cultivate. You have to take the water from the ground levels and then cultivate the land. And then he said, if you want to live onto the earth, you have to work hard and produce enough food for you to live on this earth. So the Lord, who was a farmer, who wanted to cultivate through Adam, Garden of Eden, Adam failed over there. But the Lord, the farmer, had never stopped cultivating. He was still doing the cultivation. I'll come to the next version, where Cain also was punished. Genesis 4, 2 and 3. Genesis 4 verses 2 and 3, where he says, later they gave birth to the another son, Abel. Abel became a shepherd, but Cain was a farmer. Cain was a farmer. After some time, Cain brought some of his harvest and gave it to an offering to the Lord. And Abel brought the first lamb. Now I'm talking about the Cain who was a farmer, and he was supposed to cultivate, and he cultivated the land, but he was failed in giving the offerings, and he brought the good enough of these harvests, but not the first bestest of the crop. So the Lord has not accepted his offering, because it was not the best, and it was not taken out separately like Abel. This is for the Lord, the first baby, the first harvest, the first ever best for the Lord. That was not in his heart. The offering should come from the heart. This is what I kept for my Lord. And right from the beginning, Abel was taking care of that lamb. which was to be offered to the Lord. But Cain did not do like that. He had brought the best crop out of his cultivation. There again, the Lord, who was a farmer, he sowed nice words into the Abel and Cain, but there the cultivation of his cultivation failed in Cain also. So he was unhappy. Again, I'll take you to the next version where Genesis 4:11, Cain was punished because of it, because he had killed Abel of jealous. When God did not accept his offering, Cain's offering, Cain was hurt and felt jealous of Abel, and he killed Abel, for which he was punished. And in Genesis 4:11, you are placed under a curse and you can no longer farm the soil. So Cain was punished not to cultivate the land anymore. It has soaked up your brother's blood, because it has soaked up your brother's blood as if it is open, it had opened its mouth to receive it when you have killed him. So because he has killed his brother, the blood was onto the ground. So God has punished the Cain, saying that you have done a mistake and you are no more going to soil the land. And this is how the cultivation again, the farmer, the Lord's cultivation again failed over here. But he did not stop, my dear children. He started again with Noah, where the chapter 6 in Genesis, where the sin was spreading out, and God wanted Noah to take over the ark, build the ark, and take the whole family and get into the ark, and the pace of all birds and animals, birds, and whatever God had instructed him. When he saw that this is done by Noah, he was happy. After 40 days and nights of rain, the ark had come to one place and it stopped. There again, the chapter 7, after the flood, Noah started farming. He said, "Go into the boat with your whole family. I have found that you are the only one in the whole world who does what is right." So he was blessed with that blessings of building the ark and saving the whole earth. Creations and which God had made earlier. And then after 40 days and 40 nights of rain, in the chapter 9:20, Genesis chapter 9:20, Noah, who was a farmer, was the first man to plant a vineyard. Now, after all the destruction of all the flood, Noah was the one. The Noah was a farmer who first planted a vineyard, and after that he drank some of the wine. Okay. Now here the Noah started his cultivation. Human being cultivation started here. Lord had ordered Adam to cultivate the Eden. He failed. Lord had made the Cain farmer. He failed over there by killing his Abel. Now he has chosen Noah, where he is cultivating the vineyard. And this way the cultivation had come into the human beings. But the Lord, right from the beginning, he is the farmer, and he is taking care of sowing his creations into this earth and making the human being to cultivate on his seeds. So, but where we the human beings, our father and sister Adam had failed, Cain had failed, Noah was successful. Let us come to the next version where the Lord was successful as a farmer. I just want to take you to the next version of New Testament, because farming and cultivation in the Old Testament are many. But let us have new revelation from Christ, what he wanted and what parables he has taken for the Lord farmer and the cultivation. Now I bring forward you Matthew chapter 13, 3 to 9. Once there was a man who went out to sow corn. As he scattered the seed in the field, some of it fell along the path, and birds came and ate it up. Some fell on the rocky ground where there was little soil, and the seeds soon sprouted because the soil wasn't deep. But when the sun came and it burned the young plants, and because the roots had not grown deep enough, the plants soon dried up. Some of the seeds fell among thorns bushes which grew up and choked the plants, but some seeds fell in good soil and the plants produced corn. Some produced 100 grains, other 60 and other 30. And Jesus said, this is how the word of God, when we spill the word of God into the hearts of the human, here actually the farmer is sowing the seeds, and it is falling into four types of grounds. We said it is onto the path. One is on the rocky ground, one is on the bush, and one is on this fertile line. This is resembling the Lord. Jesus is resembling this to the Lord, saying that Lord is a farmer and he is sowing his word into the hearts of the human being, and into the hearts of man, into the hearts of believer. And some seeds are being grown, some seeds have been not accepted, some things are into the bushy heart, some seeds are fallen onto the path heart, and some seeds are onto the rocky, the hearts are very rocky, some are fallen to the soft plowed soil. My dear children in Christ, our hearts are like fields, and when God spills his word, how about our hearts working for his word of God? Is it accepting the word of God like fertile line, or is it rocky, or is it bushy, or it is overseen on onto the path where the Saturn is taking the seeds away, like birds on the path have been taking the seeds away. So my dear children, the farmer in the sense the Lord, the Jesus, the words from the God coming from the mouth are directly going into the hearts of the field, the hearts of the man. This is nothing but field. The heart is a field, and the word is given by the farmer, the Lord itself, and it is going directly into the heart. And how much cultivation the Lord is able to do, the Lord, the farmer, how much cultivation into the hearts of the people he is able to do. Only the one land where it is fruitful in 60s, 30s and 100s. So my dear children, just wait for the Lord to sow his word into your hearts and be prepared for his cultivation. His cultivation is nowhere. His cultivation is in our hearts. He wants to cultivate as a farmer in our hearts. Give your hearts as a field to the Lord, and he is the owner of the land, and he is the good farmer who sows good seeds into your heart, and so that you can be fruitful and give good fruits to the world. I'll come to the next cultivation part, where Matthew 13, chapter 13, 24 to 30, where there is one more parable, the parable of weeds. Matthew 13, 3 to 9 is parable where the sower is sowing the seeds in four types of soil, and I'm going to the chapter 13, 24 to 30, where it is the parable of weeds, where both weeds and grains are both sown together, and he has compared that to the kingdom of heaven. I'll read out the chapter 13, verses 24 to 30. Jesus told them another parable. The kingdom of heaven is like this. A man sowed a good seed in his field. One night, when everyone was asleep, an enemy came and sowed weeds among the wheat and went away. When the plants grew and the ears of the corn began to form, then the weeds showed up. The man's servant came to him and said, "Sir, it was good seed you sowed in your field. Where did the weeds come from?" "It was some enemy who did this," he answered. "Do you want us to go and pull out the weeds?" They asked him. "No," he answered, "because as you gather the weeds, you might pull up some of the weeds along with them. Let the wheat and the weeds both grow together until harvest. Then I will tell the harvest worker to pull up the weeds first, tie them in the bundles and burn them, and then gather the wheat and put it in a barn." So my dear children, wheats and weeds are both together grown. The farmer had gone to the land and he sowed only good seeds of wheat. But in the night, the enemy, We call, who is our enemy? The enemy is Satan. God's words we hear, the seeds have fallen into our heart. But night when we sleep, when we think the worldly things, the Satan sows his seeds, he stalks. And he sows his weeds along with the weeds. The good seeds are there, the bad seeds are there. I mean to say weeds are there. Both together are there. And when the servant has seen, when we know, as we are the servant of children, we see that both are there, and we know that it has happened. God says, wait, the end of the time, the judging time, when his second coming time, or when he's going to church, when the harvest is ripened, he's going to take out the first weeds. He's going to take out the first weeds, the bad qualities which were sown by the Satan, the enemy. God is going to church first that. He's going to take out that first and keep the weed, that good words in our heart, and going to give the reward for us. That is the harvest he's going to left for us. So if you are with the Lord in the cultivation, God is going to take care of our farm, our land, and he's going to do his farming according to his wish. You have to be with him always. I'm going to take the next farmland, where Matthew chapter 21 to 12. Chapter 20, 1 to 12, where he again comparing this kingdom to a land where there are farmer, yeah, landlord. He has a land where he's cultivating. Shall I read for you? The kingdom of heaven is like this. Once there was a man who went out early in the morning to hire some man to work in the vineyard. He agreed to pay them a regular wage, a silver coin a day, and send them to work in the vineyard. He went out again in the market at 9 o'clock and saw some man standing there doing nothing. So he told them, you also go and work in the vineyard, and I will pay you a fair wage. So they went, and at 12 o'clock again, and at 3 o'clock he did the same thing. It was nearly 5 o'clock when he went to the marketplace and saw some other man still standing there. Why are you wasting your time? Come and join my farm. And in the evening, when he was about to pay, my dear children, he paid everyone one silver coin. The one who had come in the early morning, he was not happy with that silver coin. Rather, he took the silver coin, but he was not happy with the silver coin which was given to the last working man. But Lord said, it is my wish. I'm talking about, this is what has happened in this parable, but I'm talking about the farmer who sowed his seeds bringing the people into the vineyard to work for it. So my dear children, the farmer is bringing us into his cultivation to take care of the harvest, to work for his land. But at what time we are coming, it doesn't matter. So he says, come and work for me and take care of my cultivation. I am the farmer, take care of my vineyard and work for me. So this is how he is entrusting the work to us, and he is asking us to take care of his cultivation. There in the beginning, when it was given to Eden, it was given to Adam as an Eden garden, he failed over there. Again, the farmer Cain failed, and Noah was a successful farmer. And from then, Matthew chapter, there the farmer is a Lord. He is sowing his seeds, and where it's getting successful, where the heart is receiving the word of God, the soiled one. And again in the chapter 13:24 to 30, where he's planting good words into his land. I mean to say, the Lord farmer is sowing good seeds into the heart of man. And he's doing cultivation there. This anime is putting his weeds and making the farm cultivation bad and good. But God said he is going to remove all his weeds, and he's going to keep the weeds. So my dear children, you give your heart, the field, to the farmer, and he is the one who is going to do cultivation into your heart, into your land. So he receive him as a good farmer. Let him cultivate his words into your heart, into your field, and see the results. He will take out the weeds, and he'll keep the weeds and bundle them. And I'm talking about the vineyard, where he has his land, he is the owner, he is calling us to work for his farm and cultivate and do hard work, and he's going to reward us equally. So I'm coming to the next one is Matthew chapter 21:18-19. There's a fig tree where the Lord always wanted the fig tree to be grown and given fruitful, but when he wanted the fruits, the fig tree was unable to give. In the same way, our growth in him, in his garden, should not be like fig tree. When he is a farmer, if you accept him as a farmer and he's cultivating a fig tree in our life, we should be fruitful, not the fig tree like 21 chapter 18-19 verses. The fig tree did not give any fruits to him. And I'm going to come to the next land where Matthew 21 chapter 31-41 verses, where there's a farm, a landlord is given that farm to the slaves, and the slaves are working out. He sends his servants to take the crop, but the slaves have been killed. Again, he sends two more slaves. He's been killed. He sends his son, his word of God, his work into his field of heart. He will be fruitful, and he will be giving that land to him. He'll make as the owner. So allow the farmer to sow his word of God into your hearts and be fruitful. I'll come to the next, 2 Corinthians 9th chapter 6-11. Remember that the person who sows few seeds will have small crop, and the one who sows many seeds will have large crop. So here he says, when we are cropping the land and cultivating with few crops, it will give few harvest only. If you are sowing a few seeds into the land and cultivate, you'll get few crops. If you sow large amount of seeds into the land, into the field, you'll crop more. So this is how God says, if you let the farmer sow the words into your heart more, you'll harvest goodness more. But if you don't allow, if you allow little Bible reading, little fellowship, so you'll yield little crop only in his ministry. So my dear children in Christ, let the farmer sow large amount of seeds into your land so that you can yield large quantity of crops. So I'll come to the next version, Luke chapter 12:16-21. Here there's a parable of a rich person where he is only thinking about how to put the seeds into his land and bear more crops. And he is planning to keep all the crops into huge barns and become more rich. But here Lord says, if you are earning so much, when your life is out from your body, when you are taken away from this earth, what you are going to keep for you? See, we should not be like this rich man to cultivate so much of crops into your land and not give to anyone. God wants to develop your giving nature, and when God is giving you so much of cultivating so much of seeds into your field, let this crop go to others' benefit. Let them be benefited be with your crop. Don't keep all your blessings to yourself. Share as it a business. Share as a giving. You're giving in the name of Christ, and let the people come to you with because of the crop you have given to them. So don't keep all the crop which is fruitful to you into your barns. Let you share. You give it to the people. God was sharing. God likes sharing. God likes giving. So you also have the likeness of your godliness in yourself and try to share the crops, not like this rich man. 2 Timothy chapter 2 verses 6. The farmer who has done the hard work should have the first share of the harvest. Here he says, this is about the tithe or about the giving to the Lord. The farmer is the Lord. He says the one who is farming should have the first harvest, share of the harvest. So when God is sowing his word of God into us, God is sowing his blessing to us, God is sowing richness in us, God is giving plenty of good life to us, this harvest of first harvest should go to God. the first happiness we should share with God. That is what God wants us to do it. The same way the farmer does it. The first harvest is taken by the farmer. The farmer is the Lord. He's cultivating the harvest, sowing the seeds in a heart of field and cultivating the harvest. The first crop of the harvest should go to the Lord. So my dear children, I'm going to pray for you. Let God, the Lord, the farmer, sow his good seeds of word into our hearts. Let our heart be not rocky, bushy, or a pathway. Let it be a fat land. And let it grow in 30 and 60s and 100s. And there's a land where the Lord is owner. He calls up the people for working. And when he's calling you into his vineyard, you be a part of his cultivation. Help out in his farming. And there's one more farm where the crop is taken by these slaves, and God is taking that farm and giving to the one who is taking care of the farm. My dear children, there were weeds and weeds into our farm, into our fields. Lord has sowed his wheat seeds, but the enemy, the Satan in this world, had sowed the weeds. God is judging us, taking out the weeds and giving the weeds life to us. So let the Lord, the farmer, sow his good word of God into our hearts of field, and let him cultivate. Allow him to cultivate. So he'll be a good farmer, and he can cultivate peace, and he can cultivate these words into our life. And the result is, the farmer is a peacemaker, and the result is peace and goodness we are earning. So my dear children, take the farmer as your Lord, and let the seeds be sown into your heart, and let you harvest goodness. I ask this prayer in the precious name of Jesus Christ. Amen.